कई साल पहले आतंकवादियों ने इंडियन आर्मी से एक सवाल पूछा था. यहाँ पे वो जबान सिखाई जाती है जिससे वो सवाल का जवाब दे सकें.
There were five terrorists who were neutralized.
Yes.
How many did you kill?
My party killed four terrorists out of the five.
Viewers, this is the Sena Madhi.
Old man, he was sitting outside. I asked him, Baba, what is the problem? This lady, she's my daughter-in-law. And she's just been blessed with a child. After the delivery, there's some complications have taken place. Suddenly, I saw a six-year-old girl.
Yes, sir.
She peeped. And she looked at me, you know, like this. That made an impact on me because my daughter was of the same age. Yes. And what came into my mind? The mother of this small little girl, yes, 6-year-old, has to survive.
On 6th of October 1994, the Chief of Army Staff of the Indian Army held a conference of all the Rashtra Rifles commanders, and he told them this very interesting story. He said that in the early 90s, the Prime Minister was flying to the Northeast, and on that flight, he gave approval for the creation of the Rashtra Rifles. And then the Chief gave a very interesting example from ancient Hindu mythology. Kehte hain Hiranyakashyap ko, भगवान का ये वरदान था कि उसको मारने वाला न घर के अंदर पैदा होगा, न घर के बाहर, न जमीन, न पानी, न आसमान में. ऐसे ही राष्ट्र राइफल्स है. राष्ट्र राइफल्स न जमीन में पैदा हुई, न आसमान, न पानी में, और हिरण्यकश्यप जैसे हजारों दानवों को मार गिराया. माय नेम इज मेजर गौरव आर्या. वेलकम टू 26 बटालियन द राष्ट्र राइफल्स. Viewers, I'm in this region called Doda in Kishtwar, in the Jammu and Kashmir state. And I'm honored to be joined by Colonel Vijayant Mahadik, who's the commanding officer of 26th Battalion, the Rashtra Rifles, and I'm going to speak with him. The RR has a very interesting history, especially 26RR. And Colonel Mahadik will tell us all about 26RR, how it started, you know, right from the very beginning. And then we'll take you through in steps. You'll realize what a fantastic fighting force this is, and what a great honor for me to be here today with them. Welcome to the show, Colonel Mahadik.
Thank you very much, Gaurav. It's a pleasure to be on the show.
Absolutely. So, tell me, Colonel Mahadik, what is the history of 26RR? How did it start? Yeah, hua kaise shuru? How did it start? And what is the idea of having an RR battalion here? And how did it initially, you know, start off?
Before I tell you how 26RR came into being, let me formally welcome you to 26RR.
Absolutely. Such a pleasure.
This is Ashok Chakra Battalion.
Absolutely.
One of the only ones in this area to have had Ashok Chakra for gallantry.
Yes.
And we are fondly known amongst our people as the mechanized man-eaters. Man-eaters because we are Kumaon.
Man-eaters because you are Kumaoni, and mechanized because
you have a mech infantry complement.
Absolutely.
Well, we started about 23 years back in the history. So we were raised somewhere in the 1994 at Ahmednagar to combat terrorism. Now at that point of time, as you all are aware, the situation in this area was pretty bad.
Yes, yes.
And a requirement was felt to have a specially trained and selected body of troops to usher in normalcy in this area. Now that was the concept why RRs were raised, and yes, we were part of that raising only. So we were raised in Ahmednagar, as I told you, in 1994. And thereafter, once our initial training and the raising was over, we were deployed in this region. And we have been in this region for the last about 24 years since our raising.
Then, once you were deployed here in 1994 after the raising, how did the story continue? I remember from my time when my unit 17 Kuma was deployed in this Punch and Rajouri area. We used to talk about Doda and Kishtwar, and people used to say it's a very hot area and it's very hot, and there was like, I mean, you had Lashkar and I think you had HM and everybody here operating. But today there is relative calm. Colonel Mahadik, could you tell us this entire story? How did it happen? Because such an area which is boiling at that point in time, and today you know, it is whatever it is, it's for everybody to see. What is that story?
See, actually, as you rightly brought out, at that point of time in the early 90s, the situation in this area was very bad.
Yes.
This was in the grip of insurgency by various tanzims, and the local population was very, very unsure. Like other portions in Jammu and Kashmir, the civil administration was sort of unable to function the way they are supposed to function.
Yes.
And that is the time when the Rashtriya Rifles were deployed in this whole area of Doda in Kishtwar, okay, which is very popularly known outside as the Chenab Valley region.
Yes.
Now, as you see, look around you, you see the terrain is very, very tough and exacting.
Yes.
It demands on you. So the Rashtriya Rifle battalions which came here were deployed over a large area. And then, you know, slowly and slowly, we started getting the upper hand on the terrorists, we started eliminating them, and the locals started trusting us. We became a sort of a badge of trust for the locals.
Okay.
So wherever they saw a Rashtriya Rifle Jawan or a Rashtriya Rifle officer, we got that feeling from the locals that they respect us, we started respecting them. Because as you're aware, we operate under certain laid down guidelines. So everybody is not an enemy. There are friends also.
Yes.
There are people who are as troubled by the bad situation as a normal person anywhere.
Yes.
So all this was kept in mind. And like as you said, the biggest strong point we have in a Rashtriya Rifle battalion is,
yes,
that at any given point of time, you have a large number of people who know the area.
No, absolutely. So Kanal Madhik, tell me, I just wanted to understand, and for the benefit of our viewers also, what is the difference between a Rashtriya Rifles battalion and an infantry battalion? Because both operate in the valley, both have, if not same, then slightly similar roles in the Kashmir Valley or in Doda Kishtwar area, which is, you know, this entire Jammu region. But what is the difference organizationally, you know, in the sense that how is an RR battalion? Why RR? You already had infantry battalions in the army. Why Rashtriya Rifles? And therein lies the difference, right, between an RR battalion and an infantry battalion. So could you please tell us what is the difference?
See, I can tell you, like, you know, if you pick out certain differences which are there.
Yes.
Of course, the infantry battalions have a role cut out for them.
Yes.
Which we cannot match.
Yes.
And likewise, we have a role cut out for ourselves.
Yes.
Now, in our case, you know, certain advantages which are generally, which are there in the RR battalion is that we have a little more complement of manpower. We have little more men than the infantry battalion. Then, unlike the infantry battalion, we also have specialist troops supporting us.
Okay.
Like, you have people from the Army Service Corps or the Corps of Signals.
You have ASC guys with you.
Yes. So, they look after the MT fleet, which is as important for operations as anything else.
Absolutely, absolutely.
In these kind of roads which you have traveled,
yes,
yesterday,
yes,
you've realized that a driver,
yes,
with experience is the biggest necessity.
Absolutely.
So unless and until your troops reach from place X to place Y safely,
yes,
then rest nothing else then will function.
Absolutely.
Now to keep that heavy amount of vehicular fleet in action, so you have the specialist EME personnel supporting us.
Yes.
We have the Corps of Signals supporting us in the RR battalion.
Yes.
So if you see, I may not be wrong in saying that it's like an all-arms unit which is functioning together. The role for everybody is same.
Yes.
Everybody is contributing to the goal of, say, whatever is the laid out op role for that battalion is.
Okay.
But then everybody has got his task tailor-made and cut out. So he's performing that task to ensure that we function efficiently and smoothly. So unlike the infantry battalion, this is our major strength which we have.
Dhridhta or Veerta, this is the motto of the Rashtriya Rifles. And to achieve this motto, there is a lot of hard work involved. What makes up for the day of a Rashtriya Rifles battalion? What is the typical day of an RR soldier right in the morning till late at night?
We cannot call it a day and night schedule.
Okay.
The RR battalions are generally operating on a 24-hour cycle. So now there are a large number of activities which keep taking place at odd hours. Like, for example, our columns start moving out at 4:30.
Okay.
for some task or the other.
All right.
So if a man has to get up at 4:30 and be effective,
yes,
moving out of the company base, so he's up at, say, 2:30.
Yes.
And then he's back only in the late hours of the evening once his task is over.
Okay.
So thereafter, something or the other is happening in the night. So you've got parties which are going out for some specific reason, some specific tasking.
Okay.
Normal routine domination.
Yes.
Then the RR battalions also, we have a lot of routine administrative work. So that also keeps happening. So generally, you will find at some place or some corner in an RR battalion, somebody or the other is up.
How important a part does training play in the daily activity of an RR soldier?
See, training is structured. The whole Indian Army also focuses on training. But
yes,
however, once you're into this environment,
yes,
there is a need to keep reminding a Jawan who's in the RR,
yes,
or a JCO, and for that matter, even the young officers who are there, that they have to keep honing their skills. So, like, even in...
You can't be complacent. You can't say ki mujhe aata hai.
Yes. You know, there's a very famous saying which says, the more you practice, the better you are.
Yes.
Practice makes you perfect.
Yes.
So, now you keep practicing. So, as and when you get time, even if there are four people, five people who are available, so they'll get together, do something.
Yes.
Rehone their skills.
Yes.
You know, some kind of a lecture is organized for them, some weapon classes, or... if nothing else, then over a meal or, say, over a roll call, some case studies discussed with them, some advisory read out to them.
Yes.
Something which is told to us that it should be made known to the people, so that is done. So all this is a continuous process. It never stops, actually. So there is no set time that you start training, and now you finish training,
okay,
and now you're an op. So it's a combination of both which is on.
I believe you guys spend a lot of time in the firing range also, because I saw the shooting skills that day, and... most of them seem to be like marksmen. They were able to hit the target every single time. They just took out the weapon, they put the magazine, they cocked it, and there it was hitting the target, regular as clockwork.
See, firing is the most important. Like, you know, if you are able to fire your weapon properly, if you,
yes,
if you have confidence on your weapon,
yes,
as it is, your levels of confidence will enhance.
Yes.
So a soldier has to feel very confident handling his weapon, whatever weapon that is.
It's an extension of his body.
Extension of his body. Now, we have these drills which are in place wherein somebody comes from a long leave. So he's first made to fire on the range. His weapon is checked, okayed. And then he goes back with his weapon. So now, you can't fire everywhere. You require space for that. So we've got this place here. So we ensure that everybody fires. A minimum amount of time is spent on firing by everyone, all concerned.
The 26th Rashtriya Rifles training range, and we have Major Joseph here. Major Joseph is the 2IC, the second in command of 26th Rashtriya Rifles. Welcome to Patriot, Major Joseph.
Thank you, sir.
And before I proceed further, Major Joseph is actually from my unit. He's from 17 Kumau, and which is why we share a special bond. He's a Paltan officer. So, Major Joseph, tell me, you're firing here, and I see all of you using AKs. So please tell me, how is, you know, when a soldier comes from a regular infantry unit, where the weapon is an NSAS 5.56, and suddenly you're moving him to a 7.62 AK-47, is there any problem that he encounters?
Initially, maybe for 1 or 2 days, he finds a problem.
Yes.
But then the moment we start our pre-induction training at the unit level,
yes,
then it goes away. And finally, when he goes to the core battle school,
yes,
for the training, and by the time he comes out, he is almost seasoned.
So he's had many stints on the firing range, firing with the AK-47.
Yes.
And after all, it's a weapon and he's a soldier, so he gets used to it. All right, excellent. So in case, like, you're the 2IC, the second in command of this unit, which has done fantastically well, it's an Ashok Chakra unit, you know, we've all heard so many stories about your unit. As the role of 2IC, what I understand is that training forms a very, very important part of your role.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely, right?
You are training
is there. I mean, 2IC is always on everybody's head. Train, 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 train. So how important is firing, especially with respect to Rashtriya Rifles?
Rashtriya Rifles, you are aware of our operational role, task, as
yes,
to what we are doing here.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And keeping that in mind, main thing which comes is firing.
Okay.
Because when we get into operations,
yes,
we are against somebody,
yes,
who also knows, who doesn't have a second chance.
Yes.
And he also knows that we don't have a second chance.
We don't have a second chance. He doesn't have a second chance.
All right. It's the man who's able to fire well.
Yes. Fire first, fire accurately.
Fire accurately and fire on the target.
On the target.
You must have seen or heard that when militants or when in an encounter,
yes,
because of their poor fire discipline and their less training standards,
yes,
they try to spray a fire.
Yeah, yeah, they're like a guitar on a rock show. No, they're spraying all 30
rounds.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
But then in our Rashtriya Rifles Battalion,
yes,
we don't train them that way.
Yeah, in fact, the ethos of the Indian Army is like, you know, two rounds, three rounds, burst.
Fire discipline, fire control, fire for effect.
Absolutely.
And finally, the age-old saying, what we are taught in our academies and the regimental centers
yes.
for recruits, irrespective of the arm of service,
yes.
that ek goli, ek dushman, that
yes.
comes into play.
Ek goli, you want to make every bullet count.
We want to make every bullet count.
So, how many times are you able to fire here, and how many times, let's say in a month, do you train these people to fire?
In a month, you can say a man will be firing at least 10 to 12 times on the range.
10 to 12 times in a month?
In a month.
Which means at least twice or thrice a week, he comes on the range.
Twice or thrice a week, he comes on the range.
That's excellent. That's fantastic. I mean, infantry units don't fire that much. They don't fire that much at all. I mean, compared to the Rashtriya Rifles.
Depending on the scenario where they are...
Posted, actually. Yeah, at least in peacetime, they don't fire that much.
Yes.
Right? But this is great. So you're saying at least three times a week, these guys come here on the range and they fire.
Fire.
So which is why they become so comfortable with the weapon.
Weapon.
And, you know, this target and all that. So, this stands you in very good stead, right? When you come into contact with the militants, this stands you in very good stead.
Firing standards are good.
Yes.
You develop a confidence in your weapon.
Yes.
And then this does not become a burden for you. It becomes your part.
Yes.
Now it's my part.
Yes.
So I'm not carrying this.
Yes.
It's my part. You don't carry your hand or leg, no?
Yes.
So similarly, it becomes like that. Same for the boys. So when you're carrying, when you're calculating the load or something,
yes.
We don't take this weapon or the ammunition because that's part of us.
That's extension of your body.
It's extension of your body. That's all.
Excellent. So I'm sure you have a lot of marksmen in your unit who fire very well with an AK.
We try and ensure that the minimum standards are marksmen.
Yes.
Some require some more time.
Yes.
So that time we retain them more at the battalion headquarters, and then we send them for the pre-induction training.
Yes.
But our aim is that everybody has to be a marksman, because I told you, our playground does not give a second chance.
There is no second chance. Right. And the price for missing a target is the ultimate price.
It's the ultimate price.
So you cannot have any second chances.
Second chances.
Thank you very much for speaking to us, Major Joseph. All the very best.
Thank you.
I'll not hold you up further, and you can go back to your firing. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Detail. Bar.
Fire.
Simon, 10 jawan, alert pe chal gaye, taiyar ho?
Okay.
Ram sir.
Tanam.
Abhi tamam jawan fit hai?
Sir.
तो जैसे कि आपको पता है कि हम अगले चार दिन के लिए जनरल एरिया अल्फा वन में पेट्रोल के लिए जाएंगे मैंने आपको डिटेल ब्रीफिंग पहले से कर दिया है बट चंद एक इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट बताऊंगा यहां से चलते वक्त और दिन के समय हमारा आपसी फैसला तकरीबन 10 मीटर होगा और रात के समय और घने जंगल के दौरान हमारा फासला तकरीबन 5 मीटर होगा सिपाही अविनाश और अंकुश लीडिंग स्काउट का काम करेंगे और सिपाही स्पिंदर रेयर स्काउट का काम करेगा तीसरे नंबर पे मैं खुद चलूंगा और मेरे पीछे रेडियो ऑपरेटर पाटिल चलेगा
सब
पाटिल कम्युनिकेशन चेक कर लिया क्या
सब
ठीक है चलने के लिए तैयार
सब
कल को बता के कल को बता के कल को बता के
Seen the prowess of 26 Rashtriya Rifles on the firing range. But apart from just firing, the firer must also know his weapon intimately. He must know it backwards. He must know how to strip his weapon and put it back again, both during daytime and night. What I'm about to show you is something very special with something that soldiers love to do. Today, Sarvjit Singh will take apart an AK-47 and put it back. First in daylight, and then during simulated night time. आप तैयार हैं सरजीत सिंह?
हाँ सर.
पहले बताइए आप कौन सी यूनिट के हैं?
मैं 6 कुमाऊं सर.
6 कुमाऊं?
हाँ सर.
आप 26 आर आर में?
हाँ सर.
ठीक है. पेट्रियट में स्वागत है आपका. आप तैयार हैं?
हाँ सर.
मैं जैसे ही गो बोलूँगा, गो की गिनती पे आपका अपनी कार्रवाई शुरू करेंगे.
ठीक है.
ठीक है. ओके. 1, 2, 3, गो. सेकंड, 12 सेकंड लगा लीजिए 11.59 चलिए इसको रीसेट करते हैं अब आप इस वेपन को दोबारा जोड़ेंगे
हाँ सर
ठीक है ठीक है, मैं गो बोलने पे आप कार्रवाई शुरू करिएगा। 1, 2, 3, गो। यानी 12 सेकंड और तकरीबन 19.5 सेकंड में इन्होंने पूरा ये कार्रवाई कर ली है। अब हम इस चीज को ये देखेंगे कि रात के समय अगर ये करते तो उनको कितना टाइम लगता, क्योंकि राष्ट्रीय राइफल्स के ज्यादातर ऑपरेशन रात को होते हैं एंड हमें ये देखना पड़ेगा कि रात में भी क्या इतनी ही तेजी से, फुर्ती से और एक्यूरेसी से ये काम कर सकते हैं कि नहीं कर सकते। भाई ये काला पट्टा, मैं आपको काला पट्टा पहनाता हूँ, मैं पहनाऊंगा आपको एक फर्क, ये काम मेरा है, मैं आपको काला पट्टा पहनाता हूँ। आपकी आंखें बुरी, कुछ दिखाई तो नहीं दे रहा?
नहीं सर।
नो आई कांट सी, अदरवाइज यू वुड हैव फ्लिंच्ड। ओके चलिए, मेरे गो कहने पे आप अपनी कार्रवाई शुरू करेंगे, ठीक है? 1, 2, 3, गो। स्टॉप। 13.33 सेकंड्स, आंख बंद करके रीसेट करते हैं इसको। अब मेरे गो कहने पे आप दोबारा एक को जोड़ने की कार्रवाई शुरू करेंगे, तैयार हैं आप?
हाँ।
1, 2, 3, गो। यानी कि इन लेस देन वन मिनट इन एब्सोल्यूट डार्क दिस सोल्जर हैज द कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ फील्ड स्ट्रिपिंग हिज एंटायर वेपन एंड पुटिंग इट बैक रेडी टू फायर क्लोज टू आई थिंक 53 और 54 सेकंड्स ही कैन टेक अबाउट हिज वेपन इन पिच डार्क इन विच देयर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो लाइट ही कैन फील्ड स्ट्रिप हिज वेपन एंड पुट इट बैक अगेन। लास्ट नाइट सरजीत, बहुत बढ़िया, थैंक यू वेरी मच, बहुत ही बढ़िया काम करा। और मैं जानता हूँ कि अगर कभी भी लड़ाई के दौरान या किसी एंटी टेररिस्ट ऑपरेशन के दौरान कभी भी अगर रोक पड़ता है हथियार में, तो आप इस काबिल हैं कि एक मिनट के अंदर बिल्कुल अंधेरे में आप अपना हथियार वापस एक्शन में ला सकते हैं दोबारा दुश्मन के खिलाफ कार्रवाई करने के लिए। आप औरों को भी सिखाते हैं?
हाँ सर।
चलिए, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
I was talking to Colonel Mahadik, who's commanding officer 26 Rashtriya Rifles, about the importance of training in the RR battalions. What I've seen around me here in RR is that in some form or the other, whether small or big, training never ceases. Training is a continuing process. So let's speak to CO 26 RR and find out and figure out how it happens and why training is supposed to be the backbone. You know, because RR is the tip of the spear, as they say, for counterinsurgency and counter-terror operations in the valley, and the people have to be up to the mark each and every time. Colonel Mahadik, would you tell us, how is training a continuous process in the Rashtriya Rifles?
See, training forms the most important activity of an RR battalion. You've heard of the old dictum which says, the more you sweat in peace,
the less you bleed in war. Yes.
For us, it's war every day.
Yes.
So unless until you keep training, keep honing your skills, you know, you may get surprised. Now, that is what we don't want. So the training imparted to the boys who are coming to RR or the men who are coming to the RR is very, very structured. So say, for example, when he reports to the battalion, after giving him the initial settling down period of about 3 to 4 days, wherein his documentation is checked, his health parameters are checked. Thereafter, we put him through a small cadre wherein he's made accustomed to the weapons he's likely to use for the next about 2.5 years or 2 years of his tenure here.
All right.
Some of them are the people who haven't come across these weapons because they're not part of their normal itinerary.
Yes.
And thereafter, we have a very, very structured training for the officers.
Structure as in?
We have two core battle schools here, one at Sarol and one is right next door at Bhalra.
Okay, I've trained at Sarol, I remember.
Yeah.
When my unit was being inducted, I trained at Sarol.
Yeah, so something like this is here also. It's a very well organized training school.
All right.
So they conduct a 4-week pre-induction training for all these officers, JCOs and ORs who get posted to the RR battalion.
Right.
And then they are brought up to a level and they are told as to what is expected out of them or what will they expect once they start operating. And thereafter, once they come back to the battalions and go back to their companies, then also the training is continuous. So something or the other keeps happening somewhere or the other.
All right.
So that he remains familiarized with his role. So for that, you will realize that we've made this battle obstacle course to instill in confidence, physical fitness, that agility required to move across tough terrain.
Yes.
And in fact, I will suggest that you must make a visit to CBS Bhalra as and when you find time to see as to what they are doing and how they are going about training.
No, I most certainly will, because I remember from my time in Sarol what kind of training we did, and that was almost 20 years back. So I'm sure a lot must have changed. You know, new concepts, new weapon systems, everything must have come up in the army, and I'll certainly go to Bhalra and I'll certainly give them a look up there. And so you mentioned, so I think two things you also told me before was that, you know, in physical fitness, while you have BPET and while you have other things, I think the obstacle course is also something which is very, very important for agility, for physical strength and fitness,
yes,
I think.
Absolutely correct. You know, this small obstacles which may look very minuscule as far as the men are concerned, but however, when you are attempting them,
yes,
and then you are two, three things we try and instill in the men. One is that you work in a buddy pair. So, you know, you will see two boys attempting the obstacles together.
Yes.
Now, they have to do it together. It is not that I'll come first, so I have finished my job. So, my buddy has to come along with you.
Yes.
Now, in ops, the buddy is the most important man. You can't leave your buddy behind.
Absolutely.
So, from day one, we try and tell them that, you know, he's like your shadow.
Yes.
So he has to move with you.
Yes.
You can't be moving alone. So, these kind of small obstacles instill that confidence, agility,
yes,
to work as a small team. Because the guru mantra of CI operations is the smaller you are,
yes,
the quicker you are,
yes,
the fastest you react,
yeah,
and harder you'll hit.
Absolutely.
So you have to surprise the enemy.
And this very important thing about the buddy, I remember my CO telling me in 1994, you know, my CO, my first CO, Colonel Pathak, he used to tell me, ki agar tera buddy pass, to tu pass. Agar tera buddy fail, to tu bhi fail.
Absolutely right.
You know, either you win with the team. Winning alone doesn't matter in the army. You win as a team or you know, whatever the alternate to winning is, as a team, everything is with the team. So, we're all here, we're ready. The team is here.
The team is, team tayar hai?
Yes, sir.
Kar legi?
Yes, sir.
Good.
So, viewers, you're going to see a small demonstration of the team of 26 Rush Rifles do an obstacle course in the typical way RR guys would do it. The team is here. And are we good to go?
Yeah, we're good to go. Yes, small team tayar hai?
Yes, sir.
Bilkul?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Shabash.
Viewers, I think we're good to go now. Ask you, you mentioned this is an Ashok Chakra battalion. A matter of great honor because Ashok Chakra is equivalent to the Paramveer Chakra. How did this happen? What is the action?
See, the Ashok Chakra was awarded posthumously to Nayak Rambir Singh Tomar, who joined the battalion in somewhere in 2000.
Okay.
And that time, this complete belt was at the peak of
hot belt of insurgency.
So there were encounters every day. So this particular operation in which the unit performed very well and all because of that great soul,
yes,
was an operation which was launched in the area which is a little south of us.
And there were information that there are six foreign trained terrorists which are there. So this was a major operation which was planned, termed this operation as Agnivarsha.
Operation Agnivarsha.
Yes. And I can very proudly today say that I am one of those rare battalions which has got an Ashok Chakra for gallantry, which was awarded to Rambir Singh Tomar.
Yes.
And over and above that, I am also, my unit is also the proud recipient of four Chief of the Army Staff's unit citation over a span of 10 years for eliminating terrorism from Doda and Kishtwar district.
All right.
So that is the uniqueness which 26RR Kumau has.
Viewers, I have with me here Naib Savadar Vikram Singh from 26RR, and he was involved in one of the iconic operations for which this unit got the prestigious, the very prestigious Ashok Chakra. I will speak to Sahab, and then, you know, we can all listen into the story and learn about the valuable lessons that 26RR has to give to the people of this country. Sahab, Patriot mein aapka swagat hai.
Thank you, sir.
आप सब कौन सी पलटन के वैसे तो 26 में पहले
साहब 15 कौन साहब
आप 15 को मौके
15 कौन साहब
मैं 17 का हूं साहब अच्छा तो साहब एक बात बताइए हमने ये सुना है कि आपका दूसरा टेन्योर है पहले टेन्योर में अग्निवर्षा हुआ था
अग्निवर्षा हुआ था साहब
पहले टेन्योर पे
हां साहब
फिर आप दोबारा क्यों आए राष्ट्र राइफल्स
दोबारा अभी इसलिए आया था कि हो सकता है कि अभी फिर मौका मिले हमारे को कुछ
करने का
ऑपरेशन करने का कुछ करने का
फौजी दिल नहीं मानता
फौजी दिल नहीं मानता
है ना कुछ ना कुछ होता रहे
कुछ होता रहे
होता रहे अच्छा बात मैंने सीओ साहब से भी बात करी और अफसर साहब जेसीओ साहिबान से भी बात करी तो सब लोग अग्निवर्षा के बारे में बात कर रहे थे अशोक चक्र मिला था सब वो कहानी क्या हुई थी अग्निवर्षा में हुआ क्या था आप जरा बताइए हमारे दर्शक जानना चाहते हैं
17 अक्टूबर को हमारे को सुबह शाम को खबर मिला कि काको गांव के अंदर कुछ टेररिस्ट आकर के और काको गांव से नए लड़के भर्ती करके और पार में ले जाएंगे
अच्छा
तो हमने कंपनी कमांडर साहब को ये खबर दिया कंपनी कमांडर साहब ने हमारे को बताया कि अभी थोड़ा वेट करो मैं कुछ और खबर करता हूँ उसके बाद फिर हमारे पास में एक और सोर्स हमारा आया उसने हमारे को बताया कि काको गांव के अंदर कुछ टेररिस्ट आएंगे और आज पार लेके जाएंगे
ये लड़कों को अपने
लड़कों को पार लेके जाएंगे यहाँ से
जी जी
नई भर्ती करके
जी
और उसके बाद हम लोग यहाँ से गए काको गांव के अंदर और पहुँच गए रात में और वहाँ जा कर के फिर हमने कोडन किया
जी
और सुबह के टाइम
आपने सर्च की कार्रवाई शुरू कर दी
हमने सर्च की कार्रवाई शुरू
कर दी फिर आप घर-घर गए होंगे
घर-घर में गए फिर हम
जी
फिर सर्च किया फर्स्ट मकान को सर्च किया तो उसमें एक लियाकत अली टेररिस्ट यहां का एरिया कमांडर था उसकी ससुराल थी वहां उनसे पूछा तो उन्होंने मना कर दिया कि यहाँ 3-4 साल से कोई भी मिलिटेंट हमने नहीं देखा
उनके परिवार ने साफ मना कर दिया
साफ मना कर दिया
कि साहब यहाँ पे कोई टेररिस्ट का लेना देना नहीं है
कोई लेना देना नहीं है
जी
उसके बाद फिर हमने दूसरे मकान को सर्च किया तो उसमें भी कोई टेररिस्ट नहीं था
जी
फिर तीसरे मकान को हम सर्च करने के लिए गए तो उसके अंदर दरवाजा लॉक था अंदर से
कुंडी मार रखी होगी
कुंडी मारी हुई थी
जी
फिर हमने वहाँ से आवाज लगाया कि दरवाजा खोलो कौन है अंदर
जी
तो उन्होंने कोई दरवाजा नहीं खोला कोई रिप्लाई नहीं दिया गाँव वालों से पूछा तो गाँव वालों ने भी बताने की कोशिश नहीं किया फिर बाद में उन्होंने हमारे को बताया कि साहब हो सकता है और हमारे को भी शक हो गया कि गांव वाले भी झूठ बोल रहे होंगे शायद मकान में हैं अंदर फिर हम लोगों ने जो है एक स्मोक ग्रेनेड छत के ऊपर चढ़ करके बुखारी के पाइप के अंदर से स्मोक ग्रेनेड डाला स्मोक ग्रेनेड डालने से धुआं हुआ अंदर और धुएं की वजह से एक टेररिस्ट फायर करता हुआ बाहर निकला
वहां से आपकी कार्रवाई शुरू होती है
वहां से हमारी कार्रवाई शुरू होती है
हाँ, कि वो टेररिस्ट
बाहर आया
वहां से फिर आप लोगों ने एक्शन लेना शुरू करा
तो रामवीर सिंह तोमर और मैं दोनों मेन गेट के बाहर थे उसी टाइम
अच्छा
तो दोनों मैं उसका बड्डी था
हाँ।
दोनों साथ थे फिर रामवीर सिंह तोमर ने और हमने सब ने एक साथ उसके ऊपर फायर किया
अच्छा
फायर किया तो रामवीर सिंह तोमर ने उसको वहां गिरा दिया गेट के बाहर
रामवीर सिंह तोमर ने वो मिलिटेंट गिरा दिया
जिनको गिरा दिया वहां
ठीक है
मिलिटेंट गिराने के बाद में उसके बाद एक मिलिटेंट फिर आया दोबारा उसके पीछे थोड़ी देर बाद में वेट करके एक दो मिनट बाद में फिर आया वो बाहर फायर करता हुआ तब तक रामवीर सिंह तोमर ने ग्रेनेड निकाला हुआ था और उसने उसके ऊपर ग्रेनेड फेंक दिया
अच्छा
ग्रेनेड फेंका तो ग्रेनेड फेंकते ही साथ मिलिटेंट वहीं पर डेथ हो गई उसकी
डेर हो गया वो
उसके बाद मेन गेट और खिड़की के अंदर से फायर आया हुआ था अंदर से फिर रामवीर सिंह तोमर फायर करता हुआ मकान के अंदर घुस गया मैं उसके पीछे था मैं उसको फायर स्पोर्ट दे रहा था
अच्छा
फिर मैं बाहर गेट के पास उसको फायर स्पोर्ट दे रहा था वो जैसे ही अंदर गया फैश में उसने एक मिलिटेंट को और अंदर दाते के साथ मार दिया
तो रामवीर सिंह तोमर ने तीन खत्म करे,
तीन खत्म किए।
अच्छा,
उसके बाद फिर दूसरा जो रूम था उसके अंदर, उस रूम से फायर रहा था रामेश सिंह तोमर के ऊपर।
अच्छा,
फिर वो फायर करता करता उस रूम के अंदर घुस गया। रूम के अंदर घुसा तो वहाँ टेररिस्ट ने रामवीर सिंह तोमर की बाएं आंख में यहाँ इस जगह पर गोली मार दी।
अच्छा,
यहाँ पर। लेकिन रामवीर सिंह तोमर ने उसको भी मरते मरते गिरा दिया।
अच्छा,
उसके बाद जो ही मैं अंदर घुसा, मन जाकर देखा तो टेररिस्ट नीचे और रामवीर सिंह तोमर ऊपर और आखिरी सांसें ले रहा था।
अच्छा,
फिर मैं उसको उठा करके और बाहर निकाल के ले आया।
अच्छा,
बाहर निकाल के ले आया। उसके बाद फिर थोड़ी देर बाद में हेली आ गया और हेली से मैं रामवीर सिंह तोमर को लेकर के कमांडर हॉस्पिटल उधमपुर जाने लगा।
अच्छा,
पथरी टॉप के पास में खत्म
हो गया। अच्छा, पथरी टॉप के ऊपर जब
हेलीकॉप्टर पथरी टॉप के ऊपर से उतर रहा था
तो आखिरी
सांसें चल रही थी, शहीद हो गए।
जब उनको ऐसा लगा कि मतलब उनको गोली लग गई और उन्होंने अपनी आखिरी सांस ले ली, आप कह रहे हैं जब हेलीकॉप्टर पत्नी टॉप के ऊपर जा रहा था तब उन्होंने अपनी आखिरी सांस ली थी, फिर उनके जब शहीद हो गए वो, उसके बाद क्या आपने परिवार से बात करी? उसके बाद
कोई बात नहीं किया,
क्योंकि सब माहौल इस तरह
का था उस टाइम। बात करना
कुछ, दिस इज वेरी ट्रू, यू नो व्हाट ही इज सेइंग, आई हैव आल्सो फेल्ट दिस व्हेन आई वाज इन द आर्मी, दैट अ सोल्जर विल गो इनटू अ प्लेस वेयर ही नोज दैट सर्टेन डेथ अवेट्स हिम एंड ही विल डू सो विदाउट फियर, but the biggest fear that any soldier has is that his own buddy, his friend, his brother who's been martyred, you know, how does he tell the family? How does he go and bring that news to the family and tell the family that your son and your husband or your father is no longer with us any longer because he's been martyred fighting for our freedom and our safety and has been martyred at the altar of this nation? And this is the greatest fear. Soldiers have that, you know, that innate hesitation in sort of speaking about this thing, and that is the greatest fear. Otherwise, you tell them to go anywhere, climb any mountain, face any amount of enemies, they're never afraid. This is one thing that always extremely hesitant to do. Aap se milke bahut acha laga sir, dhanyawad bahut. Such was his bravery that 16 years on, they still remember him and speak of him with reverence and awe. Today, it is a matter of great honor and pride for me that I'm joined by Mrs. Saket Sengar, his wife, and Roshni Tomar, his daughter. Ma'am, Patriot mein aapka swagat hai. Ma'am, main aapse ye poochna chahunga ki jab hum Naik Rambir Singh Tomar ko yaad karte hain, to ek sher ki tarah yaad karte hain, jisne apne desh pe apna jeevan balidan kar diya. आप उनको कैसे याद करती हैं?
मतलब हर तरह से याद करते हैं, फैमिली के उससे भी याद करते हैं
जी,
वैसे भी याद करते हैं कि आज हमको सिर्फ उनकी वजह से इतना जाना जा रहा है, याद करते हैं सर, बच्चों की वजह से भी याद कर लेते हैं कई बार
जी,
पुरानी बातें भी याद आती हैं
जी,
हर तरह से याद
मैं समझ सकता हूँ। रोशनी, आपके दो भाई हैं, आप तीन भाई बहन हैं, आप आपस में बात करती हैं अपने पापा के बारे में? क्या बातें होती हैं दोनों भाइयों से?
करते हैं, कब बहुत कभी होती है, लेकिन हाँ होती है, हम लोग काफी छोटे थे उस टाइम पे, तो ज्यादा मेमोरीज तो नहीं है
जी,
पर हाँ करते हैं।
क्या बात करते हैं आपस में?
ऐसे ही, मतलब ज्यादा ऐसा तो नहीं है, लेकिन हाँ बोलते हैं कि छोटे भाई को बहुत प्यार करते थे पापा उस टाइम।
अच्छा।
और मुझे पर्सनली तो कोई मेमोरीज नहीं है।
अच्छा।
भैया के लिए है कि हाँ वो चाहते थे कि भैया अभी मिलिट्री स्कूल में जाए और डिफेंस में ही आए।
अच्छा।
तो कलर ब्लाइंडनेस उनको थी तो इसलिए वो उस फील्ड में नहीं जा पाए
जी,
बट हाँ स्टडीज के लिए बोलते थे बहुत ज्यादा, पापा चाहते थे हमेशा से कि फोकस था कि बच्चे पढ़ें, स्टडीज पे ज्यादा हमेशा ध्यान रहे, तो इसलिए अभी हम लोग बस वही।
मैम, आपको 26 आर आर आके कैसा लगा? आप यहाँ पे आई, इतना भव्य समारोह आपके स्वागत में यहाँ पे मना रहे हैं लोग, यहाँ पे सीओ साहब हैं, जनरल साहब भी हैं, सब लोग हैं यहाँ पे, आपको कैसा लगा 26 आर आर आके?
बहुत अच्छा लगा हमको यहाँ आके
जी,
कि आज हमने सोचा भी नहीं था कि हम इस जगह आएंगे
जी,
आज बहुत अच्छा लगा, सब लोगों ने बहुत हमको रिस्पेक्ट भी की, बहुत मतलब कैंपस में भी घूमे, सब कुछ याद, मतलब पहले कभी देखा नहीं था, जो आज सोचा भी नहीं था कि हम इस जगह आएंगे
जी,
शायद वो रहते तो भी मुझे इस जगह नहीं लाते
जी,
तो बहुत अच्छा लगा।
आपको अच्छा लगा यहाँ पे आके? आपको कैसा लगा आके?
बहुत अच्छा लगा, मेरा तो फर्स्ट टाइम एक्सपीरियंस है, वैसे आज कभी आर्मी ऐसे फंक्शंस में नहीं गई हूँ
जी,
तो मेरे लिए सब कुछ नया एक्सपीरियंस है और बहुत अच्छा लगा, मतलब काफ़ी अच्छे से रिस्पेक्ट एंड ऑल, बहुत प्राउड फील हुआ, बहुत वैसे ही मतलब क्या बताए, मतलब बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था. इनफैक्ट पापा के काफ़ी फ्रेंड्स थे, उन लोगों से भी बात बात हुई, तो उन्होंने भी काफ़ी अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस बताए, तो काफ़ी कुछ पता भी चला और बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था.
मैम, आपके हस्बैंड की जो पेरेंट यूनिट थी वो 15 कुमाऊँ थी. क्या 15 कुमाऊँ के साथ कोई बातचीत अभी तक होती है? कोई मेल मिलाप 15 कुमाऊँ के साथ आना जाना बना रहता है?
आते रहते हैं कॉल्स वगैरह.
कॉल आते रहते हैं
जी.
और
हाँ, इनवाइट भी करते हैं, प्रोग्राम फंक्शन कुछ होता है तो उसमें भी बुलाते हैं.
बुलाते हैं वहाँ पे
जी.
कैसा लगता है 15 कुमाऊँ जाके?
अच्छा लगता है सर. कुमाऊँ में आप जैसे अपने परिवार में आ गए एक बार, ऐसे फील करते हैं.
अच्छा मैम, मेरा ये सवाल है कि देश के नौजवानों के लिए आपका क्या संदेश है, क्योंकि आप ऐसे परिवार से ताल्लुक रखती हैं, आप एक ऐसे परिवार के साथ हैं जिसने देश के लिए इतनी बड़ी कुर्बानी दी और इतना नाम रोशन करा पूरे देश में, तो आप आज के युवाओं के लिए क्या संदेश है आपका?
सर, मेरा मानना तो यही है कि हर किसी को आर्मी में, डिफेंस में जाना चाहिए. ऐसे हम डर के घर में बैठेंगे तो और लोग भी तो हमारी वजह से ही रह रहे हैं
जी
घरों में, तो हमको तो मेरा तो मानना यही है कि एक बार सबको देश की सेवा के लिए मौका मिले तो जाना ही चाहिए.
और देश की सेवा से इससे अच्छा मौका कहीं नहीं मिल सकता. हमसे बात करने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मैम. थैंक यू रोशनी. Sitting at the Sarv Dharm Sthal of 26 Rashtriya Rifles, along with the commanding officer, Colonel Vijit Mahadik. And this is very typical to the Indian Army, the Sarv Dharm Sthal, where all religions find prominence, they find respect, and they find a place of honor. I'll speak to the CO and request him to explain what is the concept of the Sarv Dharm Sthal and why it is so important for 26 Rashtriya Rifles. Colonel Mahadik, could you explain to us what is the concept of Sarv Dharm Sthal?
See, Gaurav, we are basically, you're aware, we are a very secular army.
Yes.
However, religion does play an important role in a man's life. It is required for spiritual sustenance.
Yes.
We, in any form or some form or the other, we do pray to God. Now, so the Sarv Dharm concept is that all religions are equal.
Yes.
We celebrate all festivals together.
Yes.
We pray to all gods together. And we believe that it is the Almighty God which is helping us in undertaking this difficult task, guiding us, telling us that this is the right path to take, and so that we shouldn't go wrong in any of the activities.
All right. So you can do your duty. You know, we often speak about a moral army. This is part of that morality.
This is the morality.
Absolutely.
So everybody is equal, everybody is at par, all religions are equal, there is nobody up, nobody down. We are a secular army,
yes,
but we respect everyone.
I see that you have Sikhism, Islam, Christianity, and Hinduism, of course, represented here. And so you have soldiers from all religions coming here?
Yes,
and we
are a mix of all the parts of the country, as I told you earlier also.
Yes.
So we have troops from the north, the south. We have troops who follow Christianity, who follow Islam, who follow Sikhism, and of course, Hinduism.
Yes.
So they get one place under one roof where they go and pray obeisance to their God, as well as everybody else. So everybody is at par, all religions are equal.
And of course, you being the commanding officer, you're part of all the rituals and all the functions, all the prayers of every religion that happens.
Oh yes, absolutely.
That goes without saying.
Without saying.
Absolutely. So I'd like to ask you, like, you know, you are in such an area where, and the Rashtriya Rifles generally, they operate in such areas where danger is an everyday thing, you know, it's not something which is very far away or a foreign concept to you. It's every day, Rashtriya Rifles people, they face danger now. What happens in this part? Does the Sarv Dharm Sthal play an important part in sort of raising the morale of the troops also?
Oh yes, it's one of the most important institutions of unit life.
Yes.
So, you know, as you brought out, this is a dangerous area. You are operating against unknown, known terrorist or danger. And that fear is always there in a man's mind.
So whenever we start an activity, it starts with the Sarvadharma Sthal and it ends with the Sarvadharma Sthal. So we, in 26 RR, we specially believe that the hand of God is always on us.
Yes.
It's seen us through for the last 24 years.
Yes.
And we give the credit to all the glory the battalion has.
Yes.
To the Almighty, who's there. Whichever name you may call him,
yes,
he's there, so that hand is always there.
You call the Almighty by the name your religion tells you to call him, but at the end of the day, he finds, or a part of that belief system finds a home under this roof where everybody comes to worship.
Yes.
And the fantastic and spectacular success that 26RR has seen over the period of, you know, almost 25 years, it has seen that kind of success. The CEO says that a very large part of that success is actually blessing from the Almighty, because as I often say, we are a moral army, not just a powerful army. And this is a very, very large part of that morality, where you come to the Sarvadharma Sthal and then you see and think that, okay, this is wrong, I will not do this, and this is right, and I will do this, and this is my duty. And a lot of people from this unit have lost their lives in operations and keeping you and me safe. And this is the place from where they find sustenance. I wouldn't be wrong in saying that this place provides the moral and emotional sustenance for the troops to fight and actually serve their country.
Oh yes, absolutely correct. There's no doubt in that.
Viewers, I'm at the Sarvadharma Sthal, and a very quiet, a very peaceful place nestled in the hills between Doda and Kishtwar, where everybody comes, everybody prays. And if you see, which is true also, not just of 26RR, but the entire Indian Army, it's one big happy family. It is surprisingly in the Sarvadharma Sthal that differences of religion, caste, creed, race, color, everything disappears. And here, when you stand in front of your God, you're nothing but a soldier.
Not only the nature here is beautiful, the people here are, log hain jo yahan ke, wo bhi unka dil bhi utna hi khoobsurat hai. That this was not as serene as beautiful few decades back.
Okay.
These mountain tops which you see all around you were the fiefdoms of all these terrorists who were moving here.
लोगों को यह बताया जा रहा था लड़कों को कि हाँ भाई आप मिलिटेंट बनो, आपको पैसा मिलेगा, आपको ये चीज़ें मिलेंगी, तो आप मिलिटेंट बन जाओगे.
अच्छा.
तो उसी फ्लड में आकर हम लोग भी मिलिटेंट बन गए.
अच्छा.
छोटी सी उम्र
और आप उठा लिया
और हथियार उठाया.
तो आपने कौन सी तंजीम ज्वाइन करी थी?
हमने अच्छी ज्वाइन की थी, कमांडर रहा हूँ लेकिन 6-7 साल, लेकिन कुछ ऐसा नहीं हुआ यहाँ पर, क्योंकि हमारा इलाका जो था शांति से रहा. सूरज बनाया था अपने तरीके से और 26RR के सामने सरेंडर कर दिया.
इन पहाड़ों को वापस इस खूबसूरती में लाने के लिए राष्ट्रीय राइफल्स ने बहुत खून बहाया. लार्ज नंबर ऑफ आवर कॉमरेड्स हैव लेड देयर लाइव्स. दीज हिल टॉप्स आर ऑल सोक्ड विद ब्लड ऑफ मार्टियर्स.
भाई कंधे पर रमेश साहब को एक एक की गोली लगी, वो परवाह करते बगैर खून भी निकल ही रहा होगा, जाहिर सी बात है, पूरा एक एक की गोली लगती है तो बहुत बड़ा इम्पैक्ट होता है. फिर वो भागे आतंकवादी के पीछे और उसको ढेर कर दिया.
जी.
तो कितने मारे टोटल? 5?
4 सर.
4 मारे
जी.
अच्छा.
तो आरएल से मरे और फिर जो एक
दो आरएल से मरा.
हाँ.
एक रमेश साहब ने पहले मार दिया था.
हाँ.
और एक भक्ते को
फिर मारा.